Hello, this is Bern, and if you're interested in finding out what are five dangerous excuses that are preventing amazing women from finding love, well, stick around because I will be sharing them with you on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetoday.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. And for today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you five dangerous and deceitful excuses that women use but prevent them from getting the love they want. The first one is very simple, is I don't have the time. Every human being I've connected with, both men and women, have at some point or another used this excuse to not get what they want. But here's the truth. There is nothing you have time for other than that which you make time for. So instead of saying, I don't have the time, tell yourself, I'm not making the time. Now, that might sting a little bit, but that sting will allow you to start figuring out specific ways that you can use, step into, create time to go out and put yourself out there, to date, to do the things you need to do in your own life, so that you have the experience and the aliveness that's gonna magnetize the kind of guy that you want. Don't fall for this excuse. You have time to go to the bathroom. You have time to eat. You have time to watch your favorite TV show. You have time to talk to your friends. You have time to complain. So if you have the time for any of those things, I have to imagine that you can find a few minutes each week, if not more, to create the kind of life you want. Second excuse that women fall into that prevent them from getting the love they want is saying to themselves or to their friends or to me in some ways, in my town, Bern, if you only knew, in my town, blank, in my town, in my city, in my country even. And here's the truth. There are regional differences that make some places easier than others, but by far and large, you can find love wherever you go if you have the right attitude and if you have the right ethic and if you have the right level of hunger. So some women say, well, my city is too large. Some women say, my city is too small. Some women say, well, my city is just average size, but all the guys are married. I think you will find that no matter where you go, you can use this as an excuse if you want to, or you can say, I'm gonna be the exception. I'm gonna make this thing work. Now, it's gonna require more energy. It's gonna require more stepping out there. It's gonna require more getting uncomfortable. But don't ever let the place where you live be a deterrent from finding the love that you want. Number three, it's just so hard. And here's the truth. It's not an excuse. It is hard finding the love that you want, not finding a boyfriend, finding a devotional, committed partnership that is spiritual and sexual in nature, a best friend, lover, confidant, all those things in one. It is fucking hard, but is it worth it? And if it's worth it, then I think it's worth going for it. Because if you ask yourself right now, that is amazing in your life, from being a mother to having a business, to getting the job that you want, to creating the strongest connection with a best friend, what is easy? What thing that is worth a damn in this world is easy? Nothing is easy. Nothing that's really worth something is easy. So if that is the case, or at least most things that are worth something are hard, just get with the program. It is hard, and yet it's not impossible. It's not impossible if you have the right attitude, if you have the right heart set, if you have the right mindset. Number four, I don't think he's out there, therefore I'm not gonna put myself out there because he's not out there. You know what the thing is? As long as you have that beautiful excuse, you don't have to get your heart broken, you don't have to try, you don't have to get uncomfortable, you don't have to dress up, you don't have to smile, you don't have to do shit basically. So long as the guy's not out there, you have the perfect excuse never to do anything in terms of love. But if he's out there, you just haven't found him or you just haven't attracted him, that's a completely different story. So my challenge for you right now is to start saying, instead of I don't think he's out there, saying I just haven't found him, and with X amount of aliveness, passion, strategy, he's out there and I won't find him. Last one is an excuse that I see so many women step into, and I have to mention right now, is like the feeling that you have to lose some weight before you can start putting yourself out there. Now, am I saying that you should never be healthy? That if you're eating 25 bags of potato chips and 75 tubs of ice cream, that that's healthy? I'm not saying that's healthy. At the same time, have you seen men? And I'm not talking the favorite movie star. Have you just gone out there and see what men look like? And if you have, then I'm gonna say, like, men don't give a shit sometimes about the way they look. Not that that's healthy, but it's healthy in the way where they can present themselves and say, hey, take me, or leave me. I challenge you to be a little bit more like that. Not that you don't take care of yourself, but that you do go out there saying, you know what? I am on the road of getting healthier, if that's what you're going for, or I'm on the road of feeling at my best, or I'm on the road of getting the tightest set of abs I could possibly get. If that's what you are into, cool. Don't let that shit stop you from getting the guy you want, because he doesn't really care. Yes, he wants somebody who takes care of herself, but plus minus X number of pounds, nobody cares. And there's gonna be a guy who wants you the way you are right now, and go for that type of guy. Go for the guy who wants you and loves you and accepts you and appreciates you. And if you want to get healthier in that process, go ahead. But don't let that thing stop you from putting yourself out there, because it's almost like looking for perfection. And as long as you're putting yourself out there with aliveness and passion, I think you can make something amazing happen with the kind of guy that you want. So hope this is helpful, useful, insightful. If you find that it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the description of this video or somewhere on your screen, you'll see a pop-up that allows you to sign up for a free video series, or actually a video that I will share with you a blueprint on how you can find your soulmate much faster with a lot less pain than on your current trajectory. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.